what's been going on, what there's in the situation at hand. As soon as we move to the program, we help the next team. And then we just give cardiac medications, come up with his heart stuff. And we found out that he was very cold, so we tried to really measure it. We found out his hemoglobin was super low in his blood. We got him a CAT scan, we put it in a CAT scan, and then he lost his pulse again. So we resuscitated him. Our pulse was about to finish the scans. Brought him back to the room. Marks on his ankles, like they've been tied up. I mean, just every part of his body, there was just something. Oh, he's got a bullet in his lung. Oh, he's got a bullet in his foot. So that's kind of crazy. He didn't even see that at all. Different stages. I mean, he just moves up with everything he's healed, bruises up right now, like burns, cuts, abrasions, everything you could think of all over this village. All over it. He didn't look like I just remember that night thinking, I just can't. I just remember saying that, I just can't. I can't wrap my head around this. I can't wrap my head around how it got to this. Trauma surgeon, the ER doctor, respiratory therapist, so we can intubate if needed. We want an OR ready, we want blood bank labs there, I mean, every didn't get that update, and we were out. So they had horses when he first got there. Very cold, so we tried warming measures. We found out his hemoglobin was super low and he needed blood. We got him a CAT scan, he coded again CAT scan, and he lost his pulse again. So we resuscitated everything. Got pulses back, finished the scans. Marks on his ankle, like he'd been tied up. I mean, just every part on his body was just like, oh, he's got a bullet in his lung. Oh, he's got a bullet in his groin. It's like cigarette marks that he'd like, people were putting cigarettes out on him, like different stages. I mean, he had bruises that looks like it's almost healed, bruises that look brand new, like burns, cuts, abrasions, everything you can think of all over this kid. All over him. He didn't look like a child. I just remember that night thinking, I just can't. I just remember saying that, I can't wrap my head around this. I can't wrap my head around how it got to this. Standing in a trauma room that looks like everything is blown out because there's just stuff everywhere, and that's the first time that you have a second to breathe and think, holy crap, what just happened? And at that moment, that tumult was just crazy. But no, you don't have time for that. I don't think you can't stop. You can't be emotional. Does that make you need to? I don't know if I can't. this kid has never known love. This kid has never known